Welcome to the sixth social distance edition of WXP. I'm your host, Patty Heckard. Our community has stepped up to help out those in need during the pandemic through the Guardian Angel campaign. We hit our original goal last week, and now our seniors are looking to give back. Here's our student council leadership to talk about how we can help a community that's given us so much during our 4 years on campus.
Hello, I'm Ryan Marr, Vice President of the student body and member of the senior class. I have a message to my fellow classmates. As we enter the last few weeks of our senior year, normally we'd be in school enjoying the time we had left in our polos. Traditionally, polos are given to the senior class in May due to their contribution to a senior class gift. But we have been in sweats, hoodies, and unshaven for weeks now, one of the few positives of this situation. The traditional gift is tied to the graduation year. So this year, it would have been $20.20. As a senior class, although we may not be in school together, we can still make a contribution to our beloved school and home. Given the current circumstances, there is no better senior gift we can give than a contribution to the Guardian Angel Fund. The Guardian Angel Fund provides tuition relief to LaSalle families whose ability to meet their obligations has been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. It is understood that some families may not be able to contribute a gift of any size. This is okay, and be assured that your family is in our prayers. For all others, consider giving a gift that represents something that you miss. This could be a night at Wing Night with your friends, a trip to Chipotle, or an Uber ride. All gifts, whatever the size, will go directly to the emergency financial aid directed at the classes of 2020 through 2024. We're asking all classes to consider giving. As seniors, we know what it is like to miss LaSalle. By donating to the Guardian Angel Fund, we can make sure others don't miss out. Thank you for your consideration.
As Ryan stated earlier, we understand that some families are simply not able to consider a gift of any size this year because of their circumstances. That's okay. Be assured that our prayers are with your families and it will be better soon. Donations can be made out to LaSalle and mailed to the attention of the Guardian Angel Fund, or an online contribution via credit card. It is easy to hit the support button followed by the link on the homepage following the Guardian Angel Fund. To my fellow seniors, we are doing the senior project to ensure that everyone coming to LaSalle, or currently at LaSalle, can experience the most amazing community as we all did. I would like to thank you all once again and let you guys all know I do miss you all.
To help the explorers in need, visit www.lschs.org/support for more information and search LaSalle College High School on Venmo.
The AP exams will begin on Monday. Students will be taking the tests at home for the first time in history. With more on how this is all going to work, here's Director of Curriculum, Instruction, and Assessment, Mr. Coggins.
Hello, everyone. This year's AP testing, like so much of what we're experiencing right now, is going to be radically different from the experience that our students expected. The College Board, as you've certainly heard, has redesigned the millions of tests to make them take-home tests. Yes, our students will be taking AP tests in their homes on a device of their choice. They'll have 45 minutes to upload their work by a computer or by hand and photograph it and submit it. Usually these tests are 3 to 4 hours long and include a long section of multiple choice questions. This year, they can't do that section because it would be too easy to look up the answers. Instead, AP students will be challenged to think. and explain their thinking in just 45 minutes. They can use their notes or even a book, but they won't have time to do full research. So what does that mean? It means it's going to be a different experience for you guys, but here's my message. You got this. Over the next 2 weeks, 445 LaSalle students will be facing the additional stress and challenge of taking 927 AP exams in 23 subjects at home. But what we know from our past is that LaSalle's AP students can handle it. While the exam experience will be different from what they are expecting up until March, they will be prepared, and we're confident that they are fully capable of doing very, very well. So I guess that leads to my advice at this point, and that is be confident. Given you will not be attending classes on the day of your AP exams, get good rest, eat nutritiously, stay hydrated, wake up well in advance of your exam, review as needed, take a walk to clear your head, do whatever it takes to be confident going in. Make sure you test your advice days beforehand, and then sign in on the day of the exam 30 minutes before the exam begins. Get a glass of water nearby, organize your testing area at home, work with your family members to eliminate distractions while you're testing, and then let her rip. Show them what you can do. We can't wait to see the results, especially this year. Good luck, men. We're very proud of you and your teachers.
In sports news, the LaSalle community is invited to participate in our first ever virtual Explorer Invitational this weekend. Details on the LaSalle Sports Twitter. And in this week's edition of LaSalle Legends, Bob Long sits down with Mr. Parisi and the 2012 PIAA State Championship baseball team.
Hello again, everybody. Welcome into this edition of LaSalle Legends, where we gather some of the greatest teams in Explorer history and relive their finest hour. Today, it's the 2012 state champion baseball team led by head coach Joe Parisi and a cavalcade of his students and his student athletes, all here to discuss what was an unbelievable run and the school's first ever baseball state championship.
When people ask me the two best teams that I coached or who the best team that I coached is, it's you know, it's between the two. And you know, this team reminds me a lot of that 88 team. If you watch Colin swing, if you watch Mike swing, you know, when they get the base hits that knock in runs, you're going to see that they just kind of put the ball in play, hit it where it was pitched. They weren't trying to jack the ball. They weren't trying to pull everything. You know, that's just a good piece of hitting. What's that?
We had some makeup on that day. Eye black. We used a whole stick, I think.
Yeah, and then after that, the PIAA changed the rule.
Smear rule.
Yeah.
You can't smear your eye black anymore?
Nope.
No play clock to save you either.
No.
Bang.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there it is.
Being on the bottom of those piles is scary.
Kev's getting killed down there.
Oh, my. I couldn't breathe for a couple of minutes.
It's the first LaSalle baseball team to win a state championship, and it happens to be the first Philadelphia Catholic League team to win a state championship and the first District 12 team to win a state championship. So there's a lot of firsts that can't be taken away from these guys.
With the school year winding down, we'd like to take a look back. WXP's Kyle Ross asked many of our seniors to talk about their LaSalle memories before our lives were changed due to the pandemic. Enjoy this message and stay safe, LaSalle. To the seniors, we hope to all gather soon when allowed to celebrate together. Thanks for watching.
Hello, I'm Ben Howard, class of 2020.
Yoel Casadarge, class of 2020.
Hi, I'm Sean Mitchell, and I'm a senior here at LaSalle.
Hi, I'm Jay Crawford, and I'm a senior here at LaSalle.
Dylan Trainer, class of 2020.
Dylan DeVos, class of 2020, senior.
What were some of your highlights at LaSalle?
Probably one of the biggest highlights is the people you meet.
Doing my first service project, which was going to BVM tutoring.
When I actually got promoted to Director of Technology for the Lab Manager program.
Winning school presidency alongside with Ryan Marr.
Kyle Ross was amazing.
Honestly, like the overall experience of really knowing what it's like to just kind of go to LaSalle and be able to have this brotherhood, I think, you know, the whole thing's been a highlight.
What clubs and activities did you enjoy the most?
Robotics team, while I was on it, got to work with the build team bit and kind of understand like more mechanics of it all, but I did also have the chess team. However, lab manager quickly became my main focus.
Explorers Inc. was amazing.
Being able to go on Urban Immersion, I think, was awesome.
A diversity club, French club, Asian culture club.
Student council, obviously, I have to put that one first for myself because I've been involved with it for 4 years. Some fun ones I participated in was Step Brothers Dance Club, a bunch of just guys who would just get their energy out for the day and just kind of like goof around, and it was a good way to like break up the day.
Did you have any regrets or things you wanted to finish?
No, I think I'm all good. I don't really have any regrets.
I really wish I would have probably participated more in was the robotics team.
The only thing I regret so much is that I started robotics club freshman year, and I didn't follow through with that. It was just like I'd always get busy or preoccupied with something else.
No regrets, I don't think.
Taking my academics as serious as I should have freshman year.
Not being able to have time to do everything I want to do.
Would you recommend others to LaSalle?
Yeah, I would, because you really form a community with your friends here.
Yes, but I think it's based on your circumstance. Like, you have to come into LaSalle with like a prepared mindset. Like, no one's gonna hand you things.
Personally, I found great opportunities here at LaSalle, and you know, I found a lot of places that really kind of spoke to me and helped me feel kind of included and all that. I really would recommend it to anyone. I mean, whether you're interested in technology, sports, academics, community service is a huge one as well.
LaSalle, 100%.
Absolutely.
I would encourage people to go here because without being here, our band, we have the crazy band, we have crazy media production, sports teams are perennial powerhouses. I would not tell kids to go anywhere else. This is the place I want people to go if it's affordable for them.
What was something you learned from LaSalle that will help you with life in the future?
Well, I've been taking advanced communications class this year, and I gotta say, it really opened my eyes to some of the cool stuff you can do in college, and that can lead to future jobs.
I think at LaSalle, I definitely learned how to be a leader within and without like the classroom, just to be like a good role model.
Here at LaSalle, one of the things I really learned was, you know, networking and system designing, which is a very important part of becoming someone who works in the IT industry. You know, I went from just kind of having an interest in everything to actually being able to manage and configure all these devices from scratch. And that was a huge step for me.
You know, the deepest one for me is that, you know, brotherhood and family run deeper than anything.
I'd say I learned this throughout my 4 years, but probably the biggest way I learned this was going on Kairos, and that was to keep relations with everyone open. And that's not just your classmates, it's with faculty members and your friend's parents, whoever, because you never know what they're going through, but then you never know when you're going to run into them again. So it's more of always keep open arms with everyone and take everyone in, and you figure it out as you go rather than pushing people aside, because that'll never help you.
Don't go out there and make assumptions about people before you get to know the people.
Do you have any words for people coming into LaSalle?
If you're shy or stuff like that, I would just try a new club, something you haven't done before, because that's really an easy way to meet new kids.
Be yourself, especially freshman year, get in as many programs that you think might interest you right off the bat. Just kind of meet new people, meet new friends, you know, get as much variety of LaSalle, I guess, as you can.
Take it all in. Definitely take it all in. It flies.
People say this all the time of endless possibilities and get involved and all that stuff. And yeah, that's so true, but make sure to like do it. You don't just have to sit there and listen to someone say it to you, because if you sit there and just expect it to work for you, it's not gonna happen. You have to do it for yourself.
Embrace it. You're here, you got all these resources, you got all these friends, connections, all these people who are willing to go the distance for you and with you.